Hello dear student, as we were discussing about the rate of a chemical reaction ka rate ya speed, it implies the speed with which reactants gets converted into product. ठीक है, तो with the progress of reaction, जैसे जैसे reaction आगे बढ़ता है, what happens? Reactants, concentration of reactant goes on decreasing. At the same time, concentration of product increases because the reactants itself convert into product. Okay, so we can say that during the passage of the reaction, during whole reaction, puri reaction ke dauran, concentration of reactant does not remain constant. रिएक्टेंट का जो कंसंट्रेशन है वो कांस्टेंट नहीं रहता, कंटिन्यूअसली वो क्या होता है, चेंज होता है, इट डिक्रीजेस विद द पैसेज ऑफ टाइम. ठीक है, सो दिस इज द रीजन व्हाई रेट ऑफ रिएक्शन आल्सो डज नॉट रिमेन कांस्टेंट, बिकॉज एज वी हैव स्टडीड दैट रेट ऑफ ए केमिकल रिएक्शन, किसी केमिकल रिएक्शन का रेट या स्पीड जो है ये डिपेंड करता है कंसंट्रेशन ऑफ रिएक्टेंट पे. Directly, that rate of reaction depends directly on the concentration of reactant. It means if concentration of reactant will change, rate of reaction will also change. Now, since during the passage of the reaction, concentration of reactant goes on decreasing continuously, so rate of reactions also change. Means rate of reactions, once again I repeat, rate of reaction, that is the speed with which reactants gets converted into product, do not remains constant during the passage of the reaction. Puri reaction ke dauran rate of reaction jo hai har second change hota rehta hai. Clear? So this rate of reaction can be calculated in two ways, either in terms of decreasing concentration of reactant. किस स्पीड से रिएक्टेंट का कंसंट्रेशन घट रहा है, दैट विल गिव यू द रेट ऑफ रिएक्शन. That will be equal to rate of reaction, or in terms of increase in concentration of product. Clear? Because jis speed se product ka formation ho raha, that will be equal to rate of reaction. So rate of a chemical reaction can be expressed in two different ways. We had seen in our previous lecture rate of reaction in terms of decrease in concentration, jisme concentration jo wo ghatta tha कर्व कुछ इस तरह से डाउनवर्ड आता था. ठीक है, नाउ टुडे वी विल डिस्कस रेट ऑफ रिएक्शन इन टर्म्स ऑफ इंक्रीज इन कंसंट्रेशन ऑफ प्रोडक्ट. क्लियर, प्रोडक्ट के कंसंट्रेशन के बढ़ने के टर्म पे रेट ऑफ रिएक्शन, ग्राफिकल मेथड. फॉर दिस पर्पस सी, व्हेन रिएक्शन गोज ऑन, एट द बिगिनिंग वी ड्रॉ अ कर्व अलोंग एक्स एक्सिस वी रिप्रेजेंट टाइम इन सेकेंड, and along this y axis we represent the concentration. Now when reaction goes on, at suppose at time t1, concentration will of product will start increasing. At the beginning of the reaction, jab reaction start nahi hua, concentration kitna hoga product ka, zero. Theek hai, and with the passage of time, her second concentration will go on increasing, ye badhta jayega, and in this way we get a curve. Clear? So now see, at time t1, let us suppose time t1 we calculate the concentration, we determine the concentration and we got it is c1. Let us suppose at time t1, when time t1 concentration is c1 at this point, after some time let the reaction go on, and after some time again let us suppose at time t2 we are again determining the concentration. See, let us suppose at time t2 concentration is your c2, so concentration c1 se kya ho gaya, bada gaya c2. Theek hai, means concentration is increasing each and every second. Now see, this is between t1 and t2, this will give you delta t, change in time, and this one, this will give delta P, means change in concentration of product. Clear? Now as we have studied in our previous lecture, this rate RAV, AV means average rate. Average rate, how we can calculate? delta concentration of PC, this bracket represent concentration, delta represent change. So change in concentration of product by time taken, delta T. Now change in concentration of product, final concentration minus initial concentration. What is the final concentration? C2. And what is initial value? First time you will measure kiya tha, kitna tha? C1. So it will be delta P will be again equal to C2 minus C1 by T2 minus T1. So this is called your average rate. But one thing please remember, average rate do not give the true rate of reaction. Is average rate say, what is average rate? If the rate is determined over a measurable time period, मतलब एक बड़े समय अंतराल के बीच अगर rate of reaction को calculate किया जाए, then this is called average rate. हालांकि average rate does not give the true rate of reaction. Reason is that, see, average rate do not give the true rate of reaction. क्यों ऐसा? Because according to law of mass action, which we will study later on, this is one important law, law of mass action, very famous law, which state that, the statement kya hai, this law says that rate of a chemical reaction depend upon the molar concentration of reactant. Kisi reaction ka speed, jis speed se reactant product mein convert ho raha, wo depend karta directly concentration of reactant pe, reactant ke concentration pe. अब चूंकि पूरे रिएक्शन के दौरान रिएक्टेंट का जो कंसंट्रेशन है वो कंटिन्यूअसली चेंज होता है, ठीक है, दैट गोज ऑन चेंजिंग कंटिन्यूअसली, देयरफॉर रेट ऑफ रिएक्शन विल आल्सो चेंज ड्यूरिंग द टाइम इंटरवल सिलेक्टेड. लेट अस सपोज वी आर कैलकुलेटिंग द रेट विद इन 5 मिनट, 5 मिनट के अंदर रेट ऑफ रिएक्शन क्या था, तो उस 5 मिनट के अंदर भी रेट ऑफ रिएक्शन बहुत बार चेंज हो चुका, हजारों बार चेंज हो चुका होगा. Because rate of reaction depend upon, according to law of mass action, it depend upon what? Concentration of reactant, which is not constant. क्योंकि reaction चल रहा है, reactant का concentration continuously घट रहा है, तो continuous concentration अगर घटे तो rate of reaction भी change होता रहेगा. तो उस 5 मिनट के अंदर, 5 मिनट, 5 मिनट अगर या 10 सेकेंड अगर आप लिए हैं, तो उस time period के अंदर भी rate of reaction बहुत बार change हो चुका होगा. तो therefore this is called average rate. So average rate do not give the true rate of reaction. Clear? So in order to determine the exact rate of reaction, we express the rate of reaction that is called instantaneous rate of reaction. Instantaneous rate of reaction means rate of reaction at a particular interval of time that will give the true rate. Okay? Now we will discuss instantaneous rate of reaction. यानी रेट ऑफ रिएक्शन एट ए पर्टिकुलर टाइम इंटरवल. जैसे अगर आपसे कहा जाए कि ठीक 5वें सेकंड में रेट ऑफ रिएक्शन क्या था, ना 4th सेकंड ना 3rd सेकंड, 5वें सेकंड में रेट ऑफ रिएक्शन क्या था. सो एट ए पर्टिकुलर इंटरवल, इफ वी आर कैलकुलेटिंग द रेट ऑफ रिएक्शन एट ए पर्टिकुलर इंटरवल ऑफ टाइम, तो वो चेंज नहीं होगा, एंड दैट विल बी कॉल्ड इंस्टेंटेनियस रेट ऑफ रिएक्शन. क्लियर?